Hello everybody, this is our first session with a proper video presentation. We normally do some webcast, but today I thought it's going to be difficult explaining what we wanted to do in just a webcast or something. So we need a big whiteboard to explain one of the new features we are bringing in the 7.1 release called BizTalk 360 for managed services. So let me try to explain the problem we are the value we are going to add with this BizTalk 360 for managed services. It's mainly designed for consultants who work with multiple customers and they wanted to access multiple BizTalk environments from a single place. Let's see how they work at the moment. So I have put everything on the board so you know like how it's working. We're going to assume somebody called Partner One. So Partner One has three different customers. So it's ASME is the first customer, Contoso is the second customer, and Northwind is the third customer. And we are assuming all three of them are using BizTalk 360 locally. So it's present in the environment. Previously, if the consultant from Partner One, if they need to manage any of the BizTalk environments, they need to physically go into one of these environments. So they used various techniques like VPN is one way they get to the customer side, and some people they used Citrix to get to the customer side, and some other mechanism, or they didn't have the option to go to the customer side remotely at all. So what we are doing with BizTalk 360 for managed services is we are taking advantage of some of the new capabilities in Windows Azure, especially the service bus relay capabilities, and we are taking advantage of Windows Azure AD, and we created a SaaS-based portal. It's a central portal which allows the partner consultants to get to any of their customer site from a central place. So the reason I wanted to put this on the whiteboard is just to explain the technical details so that you know like what's going behind the scene. It was quite challenging for us to put all these pieces together and to make it seamless. So it's very easy to configure and to make it usable. So we don't want to go through a complex setup process. So let me explain the process through which it's going to work. So the very first thing we wanted to do is like for each partner, we will give them a bunch of customer keys. So in this case, for example, this partner one will have three keys, customer one, customer two, customer three. All they need to do is like go to the customer site, to the local site, open BizTalk 360, and we added a UI functionalities to enter those keys, what we give them. So you just simply enter those keys and say register. Once you register, it will automatically hook up with the Windows Azure Service Bus Relay and it will expose all these internal services to the outside world. And we also need to do one more thing. You need to do the user mapping because the authenticated user coming to the site from the external world will be something configured on our AD, which is going to look something like this: user1@BizTalk360.co or user2@BizTalk360.co. But here, what you need to do is you need to map that user to a local user, something like ASME Julian or ASME John. So this Julian and John are standard Windows AD users. It's staying on the on-premise environment. So you're just simply going to map, okay, when this user is going to hit this environment, he will be mapped to one of these local users. Because we don't flowing the Windows authentication all the way through from the customer side to the partner, it's not safe, and it's also no lot of challenges around that. So this is the mechanism we are following. So the manager BizTalk360.com is protected by Windows AD for authentication. So whenever the users they are going to hit the portal, they will be challenged with the standard. The Windows Live ID kind of authentication screen will pop up and you just fill in your details, and once it's authenticated, then the consultants will have access to a bunch of customer sites. That's again it's controllable, like this is you can control which consultant will have access to which customer, and once that's done, then the consultant will simply click on a customer one from this BizTalk managed BizTalk360.com portal. and they will be routed directly to the on-premise customer side. The credentials, the authentication between the Windows Azure and this is all taken care of by the service bus relay, and we use the shared access signature. Security mechanism. So it's all hidden, and nobody will have access to it because this is running on our own server, and it's all encrypted here as well. So it's all secured end to end, and it's all HTTPS all the way from this portal, from the consultant's browser, all the way through the customer side. So it's all encrypted end to end. So you can see some of the benefits of this setup. So one, the consultants are able to go to any of their customer sites seamlessly. So they don't need to follow different techniques, or even they don't need to, the customers may not be able to expose it outside. So this is one way of doing it in a secure way. And also there are a couple more use cases. Like one other use case is like if you are a medium-sized company where you don't have the infrastructure to expose your environment to the outside world. So this is one easy way. So in that case, you'll have just this one site, and you can hook up, and you can expose it to the outside world seamlessly. And it's the beauty of this is like once you see the power, it could be during our testing, this could be just a BizTalk server running on your laptop or your one of your test machine or something. As long as there is an internet connectivity, you can expose this and manage it in a public internet through a public internet within like 5-10 minutes. So that's the power of what we have done. So it's where we worked hard on making it very, very seamless in terms of configuration. So we hope it's going to be very useful for a lot of the partners, and there are various use cases it will cover. So we mentioned partners a few times. It's not necessarily partners. Some of the larger companies have footprints all over the place. We have a couple of oil companies where they have servers in environments in US, environments in India, in environment in UK, and they can apply the same technique. Like once it's all hooked up, they have a central portal, and from there they can manage all of their sites seamlessly. So this is just an introduction to give you what's going on behind the scene. But hopefully, we'll do a follow up. Presentation which showing the real portal and how it's working.